Gospel of John. I recorded this yesterday, but the first two chapters did not record right. Let's see if we can get it done today. The Gospel according to John, the Apostle John, not John the Baptist. But it does start out with talking about John the Baptist. In the beginning was the Word. Is in Greek. Arche. In the beginning of the ages, basically, the eons in the Greek, the aeons, the eons, beginning of the ages. In the beginning was the Word, the Logos. And Logos was, and the eons were prepared by him, by Yahweh. As told in Hebrews 1:2, 11:3, and Acts 11:15. In Philippians 4:15. Apokes, in the beginning. And it's also written other places. Kat Arkes. In the beginning was already pre-existent. Creation is not mentioned until verse 3, but the Word had no beginning. So the Word didn't have a beginning. In the beginning, before creation, the Word was. It was already pre-existent. And also speaks of this in 1 John 1:1. The Word has no beginning. Ephesians 1:4, Proverbs 8:23, and Psalms 92. The Logos, as spoken word, reveals the invisible thoughts. So the living word reveals the invisible Elohim, invisible creator. The beginning was the Word, and the Word was with Yahweh, and the Word was Yahweh. The Word is the subject of this part of the book. The Word is the subject, even though it's not in the English. It's not written as a subject in the English rendering. It's lost a little bit. Or Lord was Yahweh. It was infinite, it was eternal, it was perfect, it was almighty. Verse 2, the same was in the beginning with Yahweh, the same word. Was in the beginning. All things, verse 3, all things are made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. All things referring to the infinite detail of creation were made, came into being by Yahweh. All things, he created everything that is. Every single thing that was created by the Creator, Yahweh, which is what Yahweh means. I will be what I will be. I am what I am. I will become what I will become. He in the sense of creator. El Shaddai means creator, as in womb. Actually, literally means in Hebrew, creator womb. So it says in Genesis that man and woman were created in his likeness, and male and female were created in the image and likeness of Yahweh. Male and female created he them in his likeness. So he is father, but he also has within him the feminine creative aspect. He is our father. He is the seed, the beginning. I think that they make that clear because it would be confusing to refer to Yahweh as the mother of creation, because we might tend to worship mothers. It's pretty easy not to worship your father, but since there's so much creative power in a mother and she's so controlling, I think it's kind of beautiful in that he is referred to as father by Yeshua, the word. Yeshua being the Son, Yahweh's salvation, that he is the Word. Okay, I'm going to let's go ahead. All things came through him, which is Dia in the Greek. Without him, apart from him, nothing was made, nothing came into being, not anything, not even one thing. Had come into being. Nothing has come into being without God. Not a flat, stable earth, nothing. I'll be covering the book of John. Okay. apparently on this set for 10 minutes at a time. Can't seem to override that yet. So all things are made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. Verse 3. All things referring to the infinite detail of creation. By is through, were made, came into being through him, Greek dia. And without, apart from him, nothing was made. Nothing came into being apart from him, as in verse 1. As was, the word was in verse 1, came into being. Verse 4, in him was life, and life was the light of men. Life is Greek Zoe, the fountain of life. Was manifested, obtained, possessed, sustained, ministered, abounding. Resurrection, a characteristic word, Zoe. It's all the meanings in Zoe. It's a characteristic word of this gospel. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. Not a light of men, but the light of men. As in chapter 8, verse 12 of the same book. Greek, the light is phos. In Greek, P-H-O, long O-S. It's a characteristic word also of this gospel. Men is plural, anthropos. Verse 5. And the light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. Shineth is plano in Greek. In the darkness, is proposing the fall, speaks of Genesis 3:19. Where we have the fall of man. Is equal to the same Greek word, which is darkness. The darkness comprehended it not. This is direct from the Vulgate, the Greek Kato Lambano is referred to only, is so referred only here. It means overcame or overpowered it not. Overpowered him not. Darkness will never overpower Yahweh. The fall will never overpower Yahweh. It tries to. That's what the devil is trying to do. Trying to become Yahweh and steal his throne. Actually steal his throne. So that people don't realize about Flat Earth is I'm a Flat Earth believer, as the scripture tells, speaks of so-called Flat Earth. I'll take it a step further and say what I've heard nobody say yet, that the war in heaven is actually a satanic war physically on heaven, on the throne of Yahweh. These chemtrails we see are not just for us, not just for our benefit, making us beautiful and wise, but putting gook in our eyes. But these chemtrails are actually an attack on the very throne, the footstool of Yahweh in heaven, which is actually literally above us. We are actually his physical footstool here on this earth, on the face of the earth. That's what the Bible says. Face, how many faces are on a ball? There are no faces on a ball. There's only face on something that has one side to it. There's only one face to something. It doesn't have back face and front face. There's a face. There's a face of the earth. It says many times in the Bible. Okay, so shine it plain out in the darkness. The darkness comprehends not. Cato Lombano comprehended. It does not overpower, as in 1 Thessalonians 5:4. It's not overtaken by it. It's not overcome by hostility. It, referring grammatically to phos, the light, is not, it does not overtake the phos, Greek, the light. In Aramaic, this would read, darkness comprehended would read in Aramaic, Kibel, in the English we lose a lot of the beautiful poetry of the original text. And we find it in the original Hebrew and Greek and Aramaic. Kabel, with an A sound in the second one. Kabel, if you take darkness comprehended. In the Greek, it is apostello, whence we have our word apostle. This goes into verse 6. There was a man sent from Yahweh whose name was John. There arose a man sent from Yahweh. Sent is apostello. So when you say many lamps are found in the tombs of Giza. That have inscribed on them the light of Messiah shines for all. This refers to 1 Kings 9:15 through 17. We have speaks of this, these tombs of Giza and coming into the world. That was the true light, the very light, Althenios, the characteristic word of this gospel. Every man without distinction, as the sun shines on all. This is Greek, panta anthropon. Panta anthropon shines on all, not collectively, but individually and personally. The light of Yahweh shines individually and personally on each person, every single person. For centuries, Israel only had this light, and Gentiles were the exception. Henceforth, from the coming of Yeshua, from the coming of John the Baptist and forward, there was no distinction. Gentiles were to be blessed with Abraham's seed in the days of Messiah. This was foretold in Genesis 12:3, and is also spoken of in Romans 15:8-12. The light cometh into the world. This is east in Greek. The world is cosmos, where we get our word cosmos. So people want to be cosmic and speak of the cosmos. Once again, that's a good reference to flat earth. The cosmos is the world. This is the cosmos. Welcome to the cosmos. Getting cosmic on you. Welcome to the cosmos. The Greek cosmos, a characteristic word of this gospel. He was, verse 10, he was in the world, and the world was made by him, referring to Yeshua, and the world knew him not. Came and was made, the world was made, came into being, is the actual translation. And the world knew him not, is actually the word, Greek word, gnosko. Like, what are those trees that are famous for? Improving your memory. I guess I need that right now. Ginkgo trees come the same root word, even though it's a Chinese tree. You can see how that the word of the Bible reached all the way to China, infected the words. Hebrew was the original language, ancient Hebrew, not all these other languages. Gnosko, one of the characteristics of this gospel. He came into his own, and his own received him not. Verse 11. Into eis in Greek, his own things or possessions. Klimata in Greek, his own possessions. The land of Abraham, the throne of David, his own people, Israel, received him not to themselves. He came into that he already possessed. Yeshua came to that which he already possessed, and they wouldn't even receive him. You know, it's like somebody having a piece of land and allowing their son to slowly take the land from them, you know, because the child will inherit the land, of course. But then the son refuses to even let the person who owned the land live on the land. That would be awful, wouldn't it? It happens. It's called parental abuse. His own klimata possessions. The throne of David. His own people. Verse 12. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of Yahweh, even to them that believe on his name. As many as is collective, is individual, received, accepted the word, his authority, his power, his authority. Gave power to become the sons, the children. It's not male, it's the children. There's neither male nor female. And there's both. Yahweh being both male and female created he them. In his own likeness created he them. So Yahweh is male and female. Yahweh and El Shaddai actually means Yahweh womb, Yahweh creator, Yahweh's womb, El Shaddai, the creator. As many as, but he's referred to as a he is our father, and he is the seed of all things, so I have no problem calling him a he, even though he also maintains the his creator, which is a feminine aspect. They became the sons, the children, which is Greek. Technon, sons, Huios. Son is Huios. It's mostly reserved for Yeshua himself in this book of John. Huios, the son. Children is used more often. The son, the term the son is used mostly to refer to Yeshua himself. Paul uses both children and sons as referring to believers, but John uses only children. many lamps are found in the tombs of Giza. That have inscribed on them the light of Messiah shines for all. This refers to 1 Kings 9:15 through 17. And we have speaks of this, these tombs of Giza and coming into the world. That was the true light, the very light, Althenios, the characteristic word of this gospel. Every man without distinction, as the sun shines on all. This is Greek, panta anthropon. Panta anthropon shines on all, not collectively, but individually and personally. The light of Yahweh shines individually and personally on each person, every single person. For centuries, Israel only had this light, and Gentiles were the exception. Henceforth, from the coming of Yeshua, from the coming of John the Baptist and forward, there was no distinction. The Gentiles were to be blessed with Abraham's seed in the days of Messiah. This was foretold in Genesis 12:3. And is also spoken of in Romans 15:8-12. The light cometh into the world. This is east in east. Into is east in Greek. The world is cosmos, where we get our word cosmos. So people want to be cosmic and speak of the cosmos. Once again, that's a good reference to flat earth. The cosmos is the world. This is the cosmos. Welcome to the cosmos. Getting cosmic on you. Welcome to the cosmos. The Greek cosmos, a characteristic word of this gospel. He was, verse 10, he was in the world, and the world was made by him, referring to Yeshua, and the world knew him not. Came and was made, the world was made, came into being, is the actual translation. And the world knew him not is actually the word, Greek word, gnosko. Gnosko. Like, what are those trees that are famous for? Improving your memory. I guess I need that right now. Ginkgo trees come the same root word, even though it's a Chinese tree. You can see how that the word of the Bible reached all the way to China. In fact, the words Hebrew was the original language, ancient Hebrew, not all these other languages. Gnosko, one of the characteristics of this gospel. He came into his own, and his own received him not. Verse 11. Into eaths in Greek, his own things or possessions. Klimata in Greek, his own possessions. The land of Abraham, the throne of David, his own people, Israel, received him not to themselves. He came into that he already possessed. Yeshua came to that which he already possessed, and they wouldn't even receive him. You know, it's like somebody having a piece of land and allowing their son to slowly take the land from them, you know, because the child will inherit the land, of course. But then the son refuses to even let the person who owned the land live on the land. That would be awful, wouldn't it? It happens. It's called parental abuse. His own klimata, possessions. The throne of David. His own people. Verse 12. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of Yahweh, even to them that believe on his name. As many as is collective, is individual, received, accepted the word, his authority, his power, his authority. Gave power to become the sons, the children. It's not male, it's the children. There's neither male nor female. And there's both. Yahweh being both male and female created he them. And his own likeness created he them. So Yahweh is male and female. Yahweh and El Shaddai actually means Yahweh womb, Yahweh creator, Yahweh's womb, El Shaddai, the creator. As many as, but he's referred to as a he is our father, and he is the seed of all things, so I have no problem calling him a he, even though he also maintains the his creator, which is a feminine aspect. They became the sons, the children, which is Greek. Technon, sons, Huios. Son is Huios. It's mostly reserved for Yeshua himself in this book of John. Huios, son. Children is used more often. The son, the term the son is used mostly to refer to Yeshua himself. Paul uses both children and sons as referring to believers, but John uses only children.